Hi, I'm Ahuva Gamliel, a naturopathic doctor and licensed acupuncturist. Our topic of the day is bedwetting. So there are many online resources which provide the nutritional as well as the behavioral approach to bedwetting. But today what I want to focus on is the emotional component of bedwetting. Just like there are many emotions and feelings behind me, there can be emotional reasons why children continue to wet the bed past a certain age. One of the reasons is trauma. Trauma can be due to divorce, moving, resentment, maybe jealous of other siblings. It could be due to any emotional situation. It can be death in the family, anything that would traumatize a child, abuse, God forbid. Another thing that can cause excessive bedwetting or any other condition in children, it could be also difficulty holding their bowels or other conditions, but the emotional component behind it might be fear. The child might be afraid to use the bathroom or afraid of some aspect of potty training. And whether it's a rational fear or an irrational fear, a known fear or an unknown fear, that being the root and the cause of the problem must be addressed. I have this kids kit here, which has several different homeopathic remedies. And how it's done is, as opposed to being symptom-based, it's based on the child's characteristics and personality. There are over 30 different Bach flower remedies, and again, they are matched to the child's personality, not just the symptoms. The same Bach flower essence can be used to treat teething, difficulty going to the bathroom, not only bedwetting, but it could be potty training issues or any other childhood issue. Because this one, for example, it's called Aspen. This one, what it does is it replaces apprehension and vague fears with a sense of security and peace of mind. Thank you for watching. I'm Dr. Ahuva Gamliel. Bye-bye.